today, actually, I'm here to show you some of my work, and then we'll talk about it. I don't know how many people are students here of cinema. Can you just put up the hands, please? Well, I think most of them, 90%. And still anyone is working in the films now? Okay, because based on that, I thought I'll speak, like, because I need to make them understand also, because technically, if I use certain words, maybe people in the industry might understand, but students may not understand. And if anyone who's not connected with films at all, only very few. Okay, thank you. I think we have to connect the other laptop, pen drive. This is not working now. People have seen Bahubali. I think most of them have seen, or very few have seen. Then I can play the other visuals also. And Saab, I think nobody would have seen. But whether film does well or doesn't do well, no? Our work, we have to do justice. We don't know what is going to happen, what is the future, what is the fate of a film. But we try to do our best in everything. Because being the behind the camera, nobody normally recognizes the technicians behind unless your work really shows. Unfortunately, being a production designer or an art director, our job is such that people shouldn't notice our job when you see the film. It's an ambience which is created to make the scene work well. So the more you not notice, I think you've done your job well. So it's an irony for our job as such. But we enjoy it because it's like magic, because the technicality behind the magic, when they show a magician, you appreciate the magician for his tricks, but here the film works for us, actually. Ultimately, it is a film, it's a vision of the director, and it's a team effort which goes behind the camera, like the costume designers, cameraman, or the cinematographer, even other technicians. Like, I actually, if I'm a production designer, when I'm working as a production designer, there'll be art directors working under me. And in India especially, because I take my assistants as art directors, abroad we have separate art directors who is very good in period films and who are good in science fictions and things like that. But here when we do all kind of films and try to make it work the best way possible, because money, budget, everything comes to play. And I think I have no complaints about budget, basically, because I think if you have frame, because being a School of Arts student, I was trained to do a picture within a small frame, a small paper, and a big canvas, and a huge wall also. So, if there's a restriction, if you have a frame, I think it's easier for us to work within the frame, because we know exactly what we need to produce. So, there should be budget. I feel that is the one which guides us to do the best within the capabilities and the facilities given to us, actually. Let me show you some visuals to get an idea. Maybe I'll start off with Saho. Saho again was done, the heroes Prabhas, who was again Bahubali's actor. And it had a lot of action sequences. They called me for mainly for action. So most of the people whom I meet, they ask me, what you do in an action film? Because they think it's only putting set, larger than life set, and which is seen on the screen. Here, technically, we need to contribute so much because every dummy, everything has to be made believable. And because action can't be done, because safety of the artists is very important. So, but this, I think, normally I don't reveal the tricks of the trade, basically how technically we have done this to other people normally, because the audience should actually enjoy the film, then going to the technical details. But here, because people here are gathered who love cinema and to know more about cinema to enjoy it better, so I am here to present you all the things actually. I'll just have an audio show now.
The gentleman Dubai is there. We had the basic reference of that, but we wanted to make it into limited to our work.
In fact, what you've seen now is a dummy which I made, which moves also works like a sun, but it may not be able to carry weight. But that was the need for the film, so I had to do this. Then you have seen some tankers which I made, ACP tankers and pattern tanks. Those tankers I made it using plywoods and some aluminum sheets, and there was a crane inside. Actually, there's one of the pictures, I don't know whether it will come later or I've seen, you have already seen. It is a normal working crane, industrial crane, which is there inside. I removed the boom and then added the gun carriage onto that, which can again rotate. So we try to utilize whatever is available and try to make it unbelievable and to serve our purpose actually. See, beyond that, see, actually, when I started working with Malayalam films, I think it was the best experience which I had, where the budget is shoestring and they expect a lot from us. And the competition with Hollywood films, the one theater, it will be our film which is playing, a Malayalam film, which is a very small budget, and there will be a technically very advanced and Hollywood film next to it. So we are asked too much from our job by itself, but still we try to manage and give the audience the best we can do. And at the point of working, we don't think about the audience as such. Actually, I mostly think about the technicians and what the director's vision is. And it's the duty of the DOP, the director of cinematographer, to enhance my work. And basically, being a production designer, I need to see to that the colors, the coordination, everything. Sometimes we need to use brighter colors if the sequence demands that. Sometimes, most of the time we try to make it subtle and blend the whole thing together like a painting if it is needed. Especially when it's a period film, we have to be very careful about those kind of things, and we try to do our best. Well, it is really challenging. I can tell you one example. When I was working for a Malayalam film, and the next day morning we had to shoot a hospital sequence where it's a very crucial sequence in the film, where the lead actor was Mohanlal, and his mother gives birth, and he's around 35, 30, like that, and to a small kid, and the mother dies in the hospital during childbirth. And from that, he has to adopt the kid, and then he almost like a father figure, he becomes. So it's a very emotional scene, and the dialogues were written that way. So Mohanlal called me and asked me, Sahu, because the director told him where we're going to shoot. So he told me it is a marriage hall, I worked there before. Will you be able to manage, because it is a very crucial scene, it has to be really believable. So I told him it can be done. But since he asked, I had a doubt whether by any chance it shouldn't fall flat, because if it doesn't work, then it's an incentive to our job itself. So the next day, I marked another set and came back when the shooting just got over. So Mohanlal was waiting for me and wanted to talk to me. So he asked me, Sahu, I want to ask you one thing. What did you do here? Because I have shot here before, and it was really like a hospital to me, and I could have known much better. So that's the time I understood your work can contribute to an artist also. So I told him, that is fourth degree aggression. He asked me, what is that? So I told him, no, I just put some Dettol and phenyl here and there, so the smell. We threw some pictures of the... See, this was done on Lumion, in 3D model. It's a boardroom which comes in, son, I can show you the what came on the film also. This is actually, this was a different, it's a set which we put up. So you can see how much, today, those days we used to sketch on a paper to convince people, and today we can do it with lighting and show them exactly how it's going to look. So this was the set. I'm getting confused now. This is a 3D model and this is a real set. So this was a locker room. Again, this is the 3D model with lighting. And this is a real set. It's coming up. So this is the set. Actually, in the model which I've done, we have not taken the liberty to do it this way with all same size, which I changed. Those liberties we take when talking. This is again the model. This is just to show you how we prepare for the scene. This is the real set. This is the model which we worked. And whatever you see blue is enhanced by computer graphics, where the skyscrapers will come there and all that. The set was around 24 feet height. And the same, this is again the concept art. This is the real set. I feel when I'm doing high-tech sets, very modern sets, it's much more easier than a period film, but I found it very difficult. Bahubali was actually, it was almost 5 years, and I couldn't do any other film during that period, so finally settled down in Hyderabad. These are from Sao stills. In fact, this is a set which we have converted that into about 14 different sets with different look. This is one of the set. The same set is converted into 14 different sets. So this is the one which I told you where I've used a crane inside. I can show you that's the interior of that. This is again the same set which I converted. This is also the same set which we converted into another set. So you can see the. So to save money, we try to, this is a Japanese restaurant, again in the same set, same structure, but just altering a little bit, maybe moving out a pillar or two, and then just changing the colors and adding the style which we need. This is again for another sequence where the locker comes down. It was three layer set where it doesn't fall through. This is a miniature which we did. It's around 20 feet in nature. This is how it came in the film finally. So there was another guy who was supposed to be twins, and we had to take a dye of his face to create a twin brother basically, who had a similar body. And so this is how we took a cast of the face. And it in silicone. Because normally in Hollywood, I think there are specialists who will do. Here, I try to do most of the things because I love to do certain things. And this is cast with silicone, not painted yet. And once it is painted, I think it looks as real as possible. Here, the hair is not polished. Okay. Sao was a great experience because I worked with the Hollywood action team. They are the ones who are responsible for all this. Anyone knows here? I don't know because I already forgot the name of. His name is? Huh? Kenny Bates, who did Transformers. Because I am very bad in remembering names, only my work I remember. I am very bad in remembering my wife's birthday also, so she gets very upset. Because this one goes too much into, and I'm very bad in presenting things also because I want my work to speak for myself, but this time they asked me to be here. I thought I'll share it with you all. Maybe when you'll ask me questions, I'll be able to answer better. So this is a Malayalam film recently which we did, and it had two ships and it made a tank, a water tank which is around 200 by 200. And there were three ships in it, and the war sequence happens in the water. So, another thing which I would like to tell you is about the relation between our director and the visual effects supervisor, where a lot of things has to be done in CG, which is not really possible by us to create it live. Especially when it is now today, computer graphics, the texturing and the lighting has come to that level where we can extend the sets instead of making physically a 20 or 40 feet. Set or 60 feet or 120 feet. Now we are just doing it up to 25, 30 feet where the interaction, even now if it overlaps, I think if you put a blue screen, we can do roto and get it, but it's again expensive. So what we have to take care, while I think one of the boys whom I met yesterday was asking about this question, so I told him I'd answer here.